And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and I want to remind everyone, Allah azza wa jalla says in the Quran, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا. Say, O my servants who have transgressed against themselves, do not despair from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah forgives all sins, but you have to turn back to Him. You have to repent. And a lot of times what ends up happening with these relationships, and you ask Shaykh Yasir and you ask the imams that have to deal with this all the time, is that once a person delves into it, the same shaitan who was hiding from you the consequences of your actions is now exaggerating the consequences of your actions to you when you start thinking tawbah, when you start thinking repentance. You can't come back from this. So what do you have to do? You have to do more. You sink yourself deeper. Isn't that what shaitan did with the monk from Bani Israel that we spoke about a couple of months ago? Isn't that what he always does with us? And there is something beautiful and sincere about those who came to the Prophet ﷺ, repenting for their deeds. And so what do you do if you're already in that situation? Cut it off, and if it's gone too far, start to make amends. Control yourself. Go to your spouse and tell your spouse that you messed up. And I'm ready to make it right. I'm not going to wait to be caught in this. I'm ready to make it right. What do I have to do? And if I have to face major consequences in this world for Allah to forgive me, because the main consideration is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive me. That is the main consideration. You have a better chance now when you go to your spouse and tell your spouse, I messed up, I want to do better, and you cut off these things, before a person finds themselves already caught in a mess. Fix it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is merciful. Allah is forgiving. But we have to pursue that repentance ourselves.